Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Delta footprint chart, NCR chart, exactly like the one you see here. This is my custom footprint chart that I use to create ES features. On the left column here, I have the Delta. On the center column here, I have total volume. And on the right column here, I have volume profile. On the far right here, I have a session volume profile with the Delta numbers in between. So let's jump in and I'm going to show you how to build this one step by step. So you go to File, Find Symbol, and you want to go to Feature CME, and you want to look for S&P 500, and I'm gonna select the September futures contract here. I'm gonna do open intraday chart. First, I'm gonna change this chart from 1 minute to 5 range bar. I'm gonna go to chart settings. I'm gonna go to bar period. I'm gonna select range per bar 2 and ticks. I'm gonna change this number to 20, which will give me the 5 range bar. I'm gonna go to studies now. So you go to analysis, you go to studies. And you want to find numbers bar and apply. So you right click, you go back to studies again, and in the first column I'm gonna change this to ask volume bid volume difference, and I'm gonna select this to the right aligned ask bid difference profile. And I'm gonna change the color to is on diagonal dominant ask volume bid volume difference actual. And I'm gonna change this green color to bluish to 24, 142, 182. I'm gonna change all the green colors to this color. Yeah, you want to change this column 1 background cooling metal line to is on ask volume bid volume difference actually. So on the column 2 I have volume. I'm gonna go to column 2 number spar text, select volume, will show me the volume. And on the column 3 I have a volume profile. I'm gonna select this to volume profile in the column 3. I'm gonna select the cloning method based on volume actual. Will give me the volume profile. Now you can change the volume profile colors as you like. I like just the simple gray color here. I'm gonna change every single color here on column 3 to gray. That's pretty much to make a delta footprint chart on the CR chart. There are other custom studies that I use in this chart here, so I'm just gonna show you those now. So back to column 2. So I'm gonna select this color to purple, and this color to orange, and the last color of this purple also. And second last to orange. So in between these colors, if you have a background chart color to white, you can select white. As you see, I have a black color here, so I'm gonna select black. All these colors to black. So why I'm selecting this purple and orange color? So let's just say I want to highlight, if I have create volume, total volume above 1000, I want to highlight that to purple. And if I have a volume between 500 to 2000, I want to highlight that volume to the orange. So in order to do that, you just select these colors first, then you scroll down. Then you go to column to actual volume compared thresholds. So you come here, you select this to 0, and you want to select this to 500, and you want to select this to 1000. Hit apply. You come back up to column 2. So you select background coloring method. So you would select this to the based on volume actual. So now this will highlight every volume above 1000 and every volume above 500 to orange. Hit apply. And there's another setting here. If you just want to highlight, let's just say, the total highest volume in this particular bar or every bar here, so you just scroll down to the highlight maximum volume. In so our volume is in column 2nd, so we're gonna select column 2nd here. I'm gonna change the line width to just 1. So now it just highlighting, making a little box here, every highest volume here in this column 2. So that's all I use for the footprint chart, and I have a session volume profile here, which I'm going to show you right now. So you go back to studies again, you find volume by price. You add that. So first I'm going to change this volume profile from left side to the right side. So I'm gonna select this right align volume bus to the right. So yes. I'm gonna change X per volume to 1. And I'm gonna select volume warp bit to the window width. And I'm gonna select this number to 10. Make it a little bit smaller. So you go to subgraphs to change the colors on this. I'm gonna select volume bars, outline color to just gray. I'm gonna make it a little bit darker here. Probably 80. And this one to 80 also. So you come back to the settings, you go to bid volume and ask volume cooling method, and you select this to the none. This will give you just one color volume profile here. Swipe. And so I have a delta numbers in between these volume profiles. In order to show those, you go to volume, display volume in bars. Either you can have delta as volume minus bit volume, or you can show the total volume in this bars here. So I have just delta. I'm gonna select as volume minus bit volume here, apply, and on delta I just need to see only delta numbers above 200. I'm gonna just select here 200. You can have any numbers you want, and you can just put 0 to just show the all the numbers here. I'm gonna go back to subgraph now, and I'm gonna change the colors on this. Come back to volume numbers and text color here. I'm gonna change negative color to red and positive color to bluish that I use. I have another point of control. So on my session volume profile, I have point of control selected. I go to highlight point of control, say yes. And you can change the color of this to any color you like. I'm gonna select orange. So that's pretty much, guys, that's how you create the session volume profile here. There are another studies you can add to the chart also, like the VWAP, as you like, that I use on my footprint chart also. And you can add the clock here. You just go to clock. Clock build time. You can add the clock here. You can always click on the folder on this and drag anywhere on the chart. So that's it, guys. This is how you create a delta footprint chart on CR chart with the session volume profile. If you find this video helpful, like and subscribe to the channel, and let me know if you have any other questions regarding the chart. Thanks, guys. See you on the next one.